What is the message that Aam Aadmi Party is taking forward in Punjab?
You see, the Punjab is like a patient in the ICU. You pick up any field, it's in shambles, in education, health, drugs, even the finances, the employees are in bad shape. Everything is really in shambles. So really the Punjab is an ICU. We need to change the whole system. Because the message which we are taking is that this is not that we only need to change the people who are sitting in power, but we need to change the system. And that's what is needed here now. And this is the time that we need to change this. And we have to bring out a system where actually every citizen feels the true independence. Every citizen feels that government belongs to him, not the kind of that the leaders are so powerful and the people and the ordinary citizen is just like a servant.
But if it comes to power, what will be the focus areas of Aam Aadmi Party government?
The prime focus will be the drugs and then the farming, the education and health. These will be the prime focus. And there are many other things. Of course, the corruption is there, the main plank.
The party has already kind of has a framework on how it would govern.
That's
For
right.
example,
That's
there's right. have, the talk of Swaminathan Commission's implementation on the agriculture
you
sector.
You see, we have already worked out on various issues on which we are talking. We have already made a detailed plan. As far as Swaminathan report is concerned, we in fact want it to be implemented, but the center says it is purely in the center's domain and the state cannot do anything.
If you can think of objectively, what are the chances of Aam Aadmi Party coming to government?
Oh, there is a huge pay. The people are so much enthusiastic. You go to the villages and you see, there's a huge wave.
So most people say that Aam Aadmi Party has a strong base in rural areas of Punjab, but not in the cities. Do you agree with this view?
The people in the cities, they do not normally come out. They just come and vote. The people in the villages, they by nature, they come out, they're vocal, they say so. So in the cities also, the people are going to vote for Aam Aadmi Party, but in the villages, they are more vocal.
But there is also a view that if Sidhu would have been in the party, it would have performed better. Do you agree?
No, not. It wouldn't have made much of a difference. But of course, the party offered to him. He declined because he wanted something else, which of course the party cannot give. And so he has gone to Congress. I don't know what Congress has given him the offer and what it is.
But one allegation against Aam Aadmi Party is also that it has been disintegrating constantly in Punjab. What was a wave-like condition in November or September has come down quite considerably. One of the examples, many prominent leaders have also left the party.
I won't call it a disintegration, I would call it a cleansing. The party has been cleansed now. There's nothing to worry about it.
But many leaders like Himanshu Pathak of Jalandhar, who almost founded the party in Doaba region, why did you have to kind of leave him out of the race?
Because it's so unfortunate. Himanshu is a good friend. And it's so unfortunate. He had some differences with the party leadership. And I don't know what transpired.
What do you have to say about the Chotepur incident that many people still say that he is a genuine person?
You see, unfortunately, that is what had happened is unfortunate. But after this kind of allegation, party couldn't have kept him as a convener. The party only removed him as a convener. He himself left the party. Every party, they change their president. They change their office bearers, but if you change the office bearer, that doesn't mean that you just leave the party, go against the party.
Within the present organizational setup, do you think it is big enough to challenge both Akali and the Congress leadership?
It is huge. It's much bigger for both of them and combined for everybody, in fact. The setup is much bigger than combined all of them.
Okay. The Congress leadership has also been alleging that because they think that both AAP and Congress think that there's a huge anti-incumbency wave against the Badals. So Aam Aadmi Party would play a role in splitting the anti-incumbency votes. What do you have to say about that?
You see, the point is this, that now anti-incumbency is there, but it is the people are angry against the Congress also. I mean, what all excesses the Badal government has done, it is also because of the Congress is also party to it. In a way, it was the role of the opposition to stop those excesses. But they didn't do it. They rather mixed up. They had an understanding with the with Badals. So they've left the people to the mercy of the Badals.
One of the criticisms against AAP that we have occasionally heard of is that while Aam Aadmi Party practices clean development politics in Delhi, it is trying to pander to extremist Sikh emotions here, playing kind of Sikh Panthic politics. What do you have to say about
not
that?
Not at all. Not at all.
Means it's participation in Sarbat Khalsa
Aam Aadmi Party didn't participate in Sarbat Khalsa. It didn't participate in Sarbat Khalsa.
Or trying to woo Khalistani, not at previous all. Ex-Khalistani elements.
You see, not at all. You see, at one stage, the people were so angry against the government because of the killings in Delhi, what had happened, because of the riots, what had happened, because of the Operation Blue Star, the way the innocents were killed. So people were so angry. So it is a good thing to bring them back to the mainstream. So they have already come into the mainstream, and those who have come to the mainstream, only they are the one who are with the Aam Aadmi Party. The people who are already in the mainstream, this is doing good to the nation. The people who are still continuing the separatist agenda, we have nothing to do with them.
And last question, the Delhi government has done considerably good in two sectors, which is health and education. What plans do you have for Punjab?
Similarly, we will do it.
Because Punjab has a very poor schooling system.
That
right
is
now.
True. That is true.
So and you have a plan
that's
for that.
The challenge. That's the challenge.
Yeah.
We already have the plan for the health and the education. And we will improve both.
Finally, in the ticket distribution of Aam Aadmi Party, there are many elements who were previously in Punjab or who were previously in Congress or in Akali Dal and are seen as turncoats or defectors. Why did Aam Aadmi Party choose to include them in their list?
You see, many local factors need to be seen. When in your own party, you have to win the election. When in your own party, you do not have a person so strong. And this happened only a few, not even on 10% seats. Hardly on 10%, lesser than that. Lesser than that, where they came to the party, and those who recently has come, it's only on one or two seats.
So most of them are new faces.
Otherwise, most of them are the new faces. Most of them are the one who has been with the party since long time. They are the one.
So which will not be a Achilles heel for you? New faces means also new challenges in election.
No, that is true. But the new faces are good because we do not want those traditional evils of the politics to be brought by these people. So it's good that new faces, they will perform also in a new and vibrant manner.
So who will be the CM candidate? Why is there no CM
the
face?
The people of Punjab will choose through the MLAs.
Okay, and not declaring a CM candidate is a wise enough political decision?
That is true. Because we are leaving it to the people of Punjab. The people of Punjab will choose.